I was on a call with a colleague of mine from Wix, and we were chatting about the challenges and opportunities that web design agency owners are facing in 2024. I know that's a long way away from now, but getting prepped for the future is always a fun conversation. Ever watched MasterChef?
Congratulations. On the worst dish in this competition so far.
Chefs stand in front of an endless pantry, kitchen, overwhelmed with the vastness of everything they have access to until they're given some sort of constraint, like crafting a dish using only coffee. Suddenly they can whip up something unforgettable. I think starting a web design agency today feels similar to that, with a sea of tools, information, mentors, access, guidance, content at our disposal. It's really about the constraints that we set that guide us to create something truly remarkable. I was on a call with a colleague of mine from Wix, and we were chatting about the challenges and opportunities that web design agency owners are facing in 2024. I know that's a long way away from now, but getting prepped for the future is always a fun conversation. So in this vast digital kitchen that we have, having a direction is critical to succeeding in creating a memorable dish, a successful business, let's say. What's your agency's big goal? Is it landing more clients? Is it tripling your revenue? Is it branching out into new markets or creating a new type of productized service? Now, once you've identified the target, you've got to give it some sort of meaning. Otherwise, you really won't care. Simon Sinek, we all know this handsome fellow, in his groundbreaking idea, Start With Why, he emphasized the importance of understanding the purpose behind our actions. It's really not just about what we do, but why we do it. So ask yourself, why does your agency want to land those clients or branch out or launch a productized service? That why is the heartbeat of your goal. It's what gives it life. It's the story, the passion, and the drive that makes your objective more than just a number or a checkbox to be checked off. It's what will inspire your team, resonate with your clients, and really differentiate you in the market. And here's where things get really interesting. The rise of artificial intelligence in web design. AI isn't just a futuristic concept anymore. It's actively shaping and molding and shifting our industry right now, today. From automating client communication to generating design mockups, it's revolutionizing how we operate, how we move about our business. Remember the days when everything was just manual? The old-fashioned days, like 6 months ago? Well, now with AI, tasks that once took hours can be done in minutes, seconds even. For example, if you're taking notes from a client meeting, AI can help summarize those notes, drawing out key points and action items. Or perhaps you're brainstorming a business idea or a launch idea or design concepts. AI tools can augment that process and generate mockups based on your inputs. So as we embrace AI, it's important that we use it responsibly, ethically. While it offers efficiency, there are ethical considerations. It's about striking a balance, ensuring that AI augments the process without compromising on our values. We're not trying to replace ourselves. So I want to introduce you to a system or a concept that I don't claim to have invented at all. I think I just heard of this idea many, many years ago when I was strictly doing client work and shifted it, adopted it, and, you know, modeled it for my business and what I do. And I still use it today. I call it EDAM. Eliminate, delegate, automate, and me. It's kind of like our compass in the storm of growing client demands of a growing business. So as you grow, necessarily you're gonna get busier and things are gonna start to bog you down. The system gets slower. It starts to become more sluggish. And that's because you're a bottleneck. A lot of the times freelancers, as they succeed, they get more busy and lots more gets piled onto their shoulders because they're doing everything themselves. Now, the way out of that is to use this flowchart. It's a simple process that you can use to help you identify what you need to get rid of, what you need to delegate, what you need to automate, and what you need to focus on yourself. And anytime you bottleneck, apply the flowchart. Here's how it works. Every task, be it a client email or a design tweak, it goes through this filter. First, ask if the task is necessary for your success. So think about your primary goal, double your business. If that task coming through is necessary for doubling your business, okay, it gets to keep going. If it's not necessary, eliminate it. That's the first step. If it is necessary, determine if it needs human intervention. If it can be automated, then let tech handle it. Set up a Zap in Zapier, set up an automation in your email marketing tool, set up a pipeline workflow, code it, whatever you gotta do, automate it. Let technology handle that. You don't need to do it, and it will release you from the shackles of manual work in a tech world. If a robot can do it, let the robot do it, for goodness sake.
Let the robot get your damn bags, honey.
Now, if it requires a human touch, but not necessarily yours, delegate it. Give it to somebody else, an assistant, virtual assistant, personal assistant. Give it to a project manager, give it to a video editor, give it to a social media manager, give it to a graphic designer, a web designer, whatever it is. Someone on your team, someone who you're contracting, delegate that thing. It doesn't need to be you. A lot of the time we get in our own way and think, I'm the only one who can do this. It's not true. If only you can do it, like Brad is on video talking about a concept. I can't get somebody to replace that. I can get someone else to star in a video, sure. And we can shoot the video and plan the video and base it around them, of course. But I like being in my videos and I like being the one who gets to be on camera. I like communicating and creating this way. It's my favorite way. So that's necessarily mine, but I don't need to be the one editing. I don't need to be the one scheduling it and creating the keywords and the descriptions and doing the research. I could be the one creating and doing the fun part that I like and let the other part be reserved for other folks. So eliminate, delegate, automate me. So eliminate it if it's not necessary, delegate it if it's not necessary for you, automate it if it's something that tech can handle, and anything else that goes through that all the way to you, then it's on your list. And when you see that big list, there should only be like 5 things or 10 things or 3 things that are just yours. A lot of things that are automated, lots of things that are delegated, and even more things that are eliminated. That's how that should work. So it's our roadmap to streamlined operations, ensuring that every task aligns with the agency's goals. But beyond the tech and the tasks, there's a secret sauce, I think, to agency success. And that's community. Running an agency can get lonely. It's lonely work. Communities like ours, the Creative Crew community, there are lifelines. You know the Who Wants to Be a Millionaire with Regis Philbin? I don't know if you guys watched that. I did as a kid. And they had lifelines for those like really hard questions. Well, we're gonna have those really hard questions as we succeed, as we grow. We're gonna have that $500,000 question. Perhaps literally, maybe there's a client that comes along that's gonna be valued over the course of X amount of time, $500,000, and you need that lifeline. You need to call a friend. Well, that's what this is, a community for those lifelines. They offer fresh perspectives, networking, growth avenues. It's about getting feedback, sharing ideas, getting critiques on your work, and collaborating with like-minded professionals. So, to wrap this up, I think the web design scene in 2024 is going to be a mixed bag of challenges and opportunities. But if you've got clear goals, some artificial intelligence on board in the right way, you got that EDAM flowchart locked down and a strong community, well, I believe the sky's the limit for your web design agency. So I'd recommend that any serious web design agency owner or freelancer consider joining us in the Creative Crew community. It's free to join, and the link is down below in the description and the pinned comment, and we'll see you there on one of our upcoming live events, virtual meetups, networking sessions, or critiques. Now go build something.